Okay, I guess we can go ahead and get started. If anybody comes in later, we'll catch them up to speed. And we are being recorded, so anyone else can watch. So good afternoon. On behalf of SUNY OER Services, I want to welcome you to today's webinar on Waymaker for College Success. I'm Michelle Beachy, SUNY OER Services Campus Strategist, and I'm joined today by Allison Andrunas from Lumen Learning, Director of Teaching and Learning for English and College Success, and Laura Murray, also with Lumen, who will be monitoring the chat. Feel free to jump in at any time if you have a question. So I'll just begin by providing a brief overview of SUNY OER Services and the partnership that SUNY has with Lumen Learning. And then we'll move into a live demonstration of Waymaker for College Success. We'll leave time at the end for questions, but again, feel free to jump in to either the Q&A or the chat, or just unmute yourself if you have a question, and we will be happy to answer any questions. So over the last 2 years, more than 155,000 SUNY students and 1,000 SUNY faculty have embraced the freedom and power of OER. SUNY OER Services is building on that momentum, but we can't scale and sustain OER across SUNY alone. We need partners. And Lumen is a leader in OER and a natural partner for SUNY, given its experience, expertise, and leadership in open education. Together, we help campuses remove barriers, offer affordable and easy-to-access, adaptable open course materials. Lumen Learning's vision is to enable unprecedented learning for all students and impact affordability, access, and student outcomes through effective adoption of open educational resources at scale. And this aligns with SUNY's mission to offer the people of New York educational services of the highest quality with the broadest possible access. Lumen Learning is a partner that listens to the needs of SUNY faculty, responds to the latest educational technological capabilities, incorporates OER into those technologies, and uses data to improve OER efforts. Lumen's OER courses and platforms are available to all SUNY faculty and students at no charge through this system-level partnership. SUNY OER Services and the SUNY Help Desk provide direct support for faculty and students using Lumen's platforms and OER courses. It's as simple as sending an email to suny@oer.edu, and that gets filtered. We have dedicated staff at our SUNY Help Desk. They filter your request, your question, to SUNY OER Services and or Lumen, and we're all available to help you anytime. Together, we're intensely focused on ensuring data-driven, high-quality OER is available to SUNY students on day one, that the resources are offered at an affordable cost. In SUNY's case, that's free, very affordable. But the most important goal is to improve our student success. So in the SUNY Ready to Adopt OER course catalog, which is at oer.suny.edu, you will find peer-reviewed course materials and ancillary teaching resources for over 70 subjects, all of which are available, again, at no cost to SUNY students. So if we take a quick look at our catalog, we have a section where you can search by subject. In the search bar, you can search by keyword, and then you can just browse through all of the courses that we have available and are ready to adopt catalog. Each of these does show which type of platform they're available in. Specifically today, we'll be talking about how Waymaker can help you in your course. And I'm going to turn the controls over to Allison with Lumen, and she's going to give a demonstration of Waymaker courseware that combines OER with personalized learning tools and analytics to strengthen student learning and success. So let me stop sharing on my end and pass that over to Allison.
Okay, thank you so much, Michelle. I'm gonna make sure, can you see my screen I've done these webinars before where I've been halfway through and no one could see my screen. So that's so wanted to make sure there. Okay, so what I'm showing you right now is SUNY's instance of Blackboard with a combination of the Lumen materials. And we call it college success, but it's first year experience in New York. So I'm going to call it the first year experience course because that shows how highly adaptable our catalog is. It's also called the freshman experience someplace. It's also called study skills in another place. It's called learning frameworks in another state. So everybody has their own version of college success. And as a former college success teacher, I will tell you, it is typically the student, the class that students like to take the least. So let me talk to you a little bit about that experience. And if you've had that experience where some students, like early in the school year, they enjoy it, they get a lot out of it. And then one of the things that has happened over the years is that we're catching students in the very beginning of their college experience, so they're not as bitter about it. Back when I taught it, we didn't have the tools to catch those students. So I would have a student who was like 5 credits from graduating and they had to take my college success course. And so that was really helpful to teach a student who was about to become a nurse how to study. And so this course in particular with Lumens, I have been a part of the building of this course, and I have spoken with a lot of our partners who have adopted college success. And we've got a great example with Monroe there in New York, and some other schools in Indiana and Iowa and Texas in particular have scaled the use of this course. And one of the ways that I talk about our college success course or first year experience is that it really is a course that can partner with what you've already built. There has been a lot of investment in college success or first year experience in building a customized, and I use air quotes as a little bit of a joke there, because this course is changing all the time based on different initiatives and what schools are trying to do. And so with the way I describe Waymaker is that it really works as almost like a workbook. So you have all of the things that you have probably built in your learning management system, you know, about study skills and the writing center and going to the library and basically all of the things that we have decided that help students become successful in their first year. So Waymaker really works as the workbook where a student goes through exercises and goes through the experience of learning about how to be a college student. And if you're teaching at a community college and more at a regional public, you know that we do not have just freshmen straight out of high school. They are not, these are adults. These are people who are sometimes second and third career. So it was very important to us that we build a course that isn't just targeted towards that, you know, student that's fresh out of mom and dad's house for the very first time. A lot of college success or transitional studies or first year experience courses are really built around this, I've never been out of mom and dad's house before. And I found that very insulting as a teacher who was trying to study adult learning. And, you know, it's also kind of insulting to an 18-year-old who's already had a job, who has actually been paying, you know, to help support the household. And just because they've moved out of their house for the first time doesn't mean that they are, they're not an adult. So we've tried to put together a course that really gets into how to be a successful student. So our college success course, and I can help you through this, and Laura can help you through this as well as part of our partnership, but we really can set up this college success course to work for a 4-week, a 6-week, 8-week, 10-week, 12-week, 14, 16-week, even a 2-week. And it works well with any of your customized materials. I've aligned some of the learning objectives that I was able to find from a first year experience course. And I copied each of our learning objectives that go with all of our folders or our modules. So these are the course that come through as a file for Waymaker. This course meets any adult basic ed, transitional studies, study skills, any interdisciplinary interdisciplinary. So some people teach college success as an interdisciplinary subject, which actually was my favorite. You got to take an art appreciation course along with a college success course. Those were actually my favorite to be a part of, because you got to actually, apply the materials for college success in an actual discipline. And we have targeted all students, I feel like, because the main objective of this course, in my opinion, is to build the confidence of students. They're going to get their souls crushed in composition and college algebra. So let's get them feeling good about being a student and learning things that they actually need. That was a joke, by the way. We're setting them up for harder courses. So in each of these folders, this is what it looks like. And let's say you want to teach motivating success before you teach goal setting and time management. You're welcome to do that. If you do not teach career exploration, because that's not part of what you do, maybe that's something they get in a later course, you can use Blackboard to delete that part of the course. And when you click into, and just to kind of get into the student experience here, when you click into study skills, because let's face it, that's the heart of college success, you'll see that there are way more materials than you can possibly ever use. And you'll find that in a lot of Lumen's courses, if not all of them, where we are giving you more than what you can use, because we have found over the years that faculty members love deleting course materials, but they're not so crazy about building them or writing them. A lot of the early, I would say, myths of OER, it wasn't so much a myth. You really had to build, you had to write a course because there weren't materials out there. There is no reason why anybody at this point in time should have to write a college success course or a first year experience. There is so much information out there. And Lumen has an answer for this course. I wouldn't say that we have the answer, because lots of schools like to do things very specifically, but I think we've got an answer to partner with whatever you have created locally. So let's say you've got a college success course, you've got a lot of assignments, you've worked hard with your department, and you really just want to get to teaching these materials, these learning objectives in particular. Each course, and I've already activated what it looks like after a student has started to interact with the study plan. She's gone through and she's read something about why it matters. So in other words, from a student's perspective, why we're making you study this. And these are short conversational pieces that help a student understand, why we're making you study these items. You then do, as a student, you do a show what you know, and the show what you know activates the study plan. And it basically says, hey student, after this diagnostic test, here are some areas where you're on track and here's where you need some work. And so as a student, I can say I'm that busy adult returning student who has a job, has a family, has already spent a fair amount of time commuting to campus, or I'm an online student and I'm doing this in between my break at work. I can say, all right, I'm ready to start reading strategies. I want to get to it. I open up this part, this tile of the study plan. We call it a study plan. You could call it chapter readings. You could call it your unit, whatever language you use with your students. And when you open up each of these pages, it renders right in Blackboard. And so the student never leaves Blackboard. They get that day one access. They get that access to their materials, and they can use the navigation within Waymaker that keeps them in Blackboard. They have short reading materials. All of the images have alt text. All of the videos will be captioned, so you cover your ground there for any accessibility concerns. And then for each of the videos, they are captioned. And then, for those of you that are interested in the attributions of where this materials come from, all of our attributions are on the page. We hide them because typically students don't care. They're not as interested. They really just want to do the reading and do their assignments. So we've hidden that to give the students a real focused experience, because let's face it, the attribution, unless you're really into Creative Commons licensing, just isn't that exciting to look at. But our attribution builder is pretty cool. It's one of the features that I think is really great about the Lumen platform, is that you can start using open educational resources without having to worry about staying within the law of copyright. We have self-checks. So what these do, and I'm going to take a chance here very quickly to take a self-check with our, where I'm guessing. It seems like every time I do a self-check and I guess, I get a lot correct, more than I would have if I was a student. And here you can see that Waymaker is interacting where a student focuses on metacognition, where I was pretty sure that I knew this answer, but hey, I'm actually incorrect. A student can retake these assessments as many times as they like. It helps them study. And so each individual student will have this personalized experience. And what that really means is that a student stays within the confines or the design of the course, and they study the materials that are a part of the learning objectives, but they can focus on what they are interested in learning about and where they need to improve. So that's where Waymaker is an adaptive platform. And Lumen is interested in making people smarter, not the platform itself. And so when students interact with it, they get that study plan, they get that feedback. We also, for this to support students, we also have a module that's called Succeeding with Waymaker, and this is a short tutorial on basically having the mindset of a Waymaker student, where we're mainly trying to get you to think about where you need to slow down and think about your thinking and think about your learning. So again, this can work as a week zero. When I consult with teachers, I usually tell them to go ahead and publish this as their week zero, publish their announcement, and they're all ready to start teaching the class. And they meet that requirement of a week zero so that students can log in and get to know the platform a bit before the class actually starts. So again, we've got all of these learning objectives here, and the best way to really see if this is the course for you is to contact SUNY to see if we can get you a cartridge or a file, and you are more than welcome to have this. So we connect with Blackboard within the New York system, and then you can have that sort of desktop experience where you can take a course for a test drive and get to know all of the materials and all the learning objectives that are part of the course. So we've covered the student side of it. We've got the design. We keep them in Blackboard. We've got all the ability for you to customize there with any materials that you have. And we're looking at ways to save the students' time. So how do we save teachers' time? This is something that I was always interested in as a teacher. Why go into the digital space? Why look for innovative ways of teaching if it was actually going to take me more time? And so one of the things that's very important to us at Lumen is to give the teacher a starting point, and then you can customize the course from there. And so the way we do this is that we deliver the ancillary materials that you're used to, like PowerPoints, the quiz bank. We also offer a PDF of the course so that if you're concerned about your students having offline access, they have access to the PDF and they can download it. The majority of the students that I've worked with, they download it onto their phones and they read the materials on their phones. And if we're looking at ways that students can target their learning and with their precious time, what can we do for teachers where we're saving teachers' time so that we can maximize the time that teachers are spending with students? I mean, really, when we talk about good design in courses, we're talking about three major levels of interaction: how students interact with one another, how students interact with content, how students interact with the teachers. This is Quality Matters 101 for you, for those of you that have done Quality Matters training. The student-to-student interaction, that really is up to you as a teacher. That's something that you do with your expertise as a college success or a first-year experienced teacher. And I think that Lumen can help here with the students' interaction to the content, and then most importantly, the students' interaction with you, the teacher. We've got this dashboard that helps communicate that crucial interaction. And we do have the ability to turn off what we call our automated messaging or our faculty tools. But I always recommend use it. Try it for the first time. And if you don't like it, then you can turn it off and, you know, live your life. But why not try the best of the features as it's designed to see if it helps. The majority of the faculty members that we have been working with, they really really like that messaging with the students. And this, and Waymaker is basically looking at communicating with all students. So whether you're communicating with the A student that's just rocking first year experience, or a student that's really struggling, Waymaker sends both democratically. And as a teacher, I have to tell you that that was one of the most difficult parts of teaching for me. I typically gave a pat on the back to the A students and set them free to focus on whatever they wanted to. And then I had to focus my time on the students that were struggling. So I didn't have as much interaction with the students that were doing really well. So this, you know, these little messages that go out. And so let me show you what this looks like. When you're coming into the faculty tools, you get this dashboard. So I'm going to get rid of this really quickly, just so I can show you what this looks like here. The faculty tools. We have more that you can read about. So in your free time, if you would like some professional development via Waymaker, you're welcome to do that. But I'm going to dismiss that for now because I want to talk about these three students that are struggling in my class. So Waymaker gives me this quick report and says, "Hey, teacher, you got three students that after their second attempt on the quiz, they're struggling. So what can you do?" And as a teacher, I could look at my Blackboard analytics, I can look at my grade book, I can look at my notes about what's happening in the class. But really, the fastest thing I can do here with Waymaker is I can say, all right, I've got three students. You know what? Michaela followed me to my car to talk to me. She is really driven to do well in my class. She was freaking out about that 70%. I've already talked to her. I have in my notes our discussion. She's good. So now I can target this 20 minutes I've got to interact with my students. And I'm going to take a look here of what's going on with Daniel. I get this report of Daniel's interaction with the learning outcomes. I can see that he didn't do too hot on the self-checks. There's something going on. And I get this option to send a message. So as a teacher, when I taught online, hybrid, face-to-face, I kept a 50-page Word document of the things that I said to students over and over and over again in my 12-year history of teaching. And I would, you know, use those as shortcuts because, let's face it, I had some typical things that I would say to students. And Waymaker automatically populates a message that I would have sent to my student. It makes it really easy to email a student right here. You can also add, if you could type, you could also add new ideas here. I could add a little cat meme if I wanted to. I could include a YouTube video. I could take a picture of my dog, whatever I wanted, and I could personalize that and send it very quickly to students. And I think that's very powerful. That student to teacher interaction, when there's one of you and 150 of them, that is the reality of most of our adjunct faculty in particular. So shout out to you adjuncts if you're looking at this later on because you don't have time during your day for any professional development. Thank you for joining us today. I want to acknowledge that your job's really hard and you are welcome to try Waymaker as part of the New York system to see if it can help you save time in interacting with your students. The other thing that we can do is send a tip. So you can customize this, and I'll show you this here quickly, where you can set up messages where you send to your students a little bit of a quick tip. So I broke the record with how many times I told students to go to the writing center or go to the tutorial center or go to the library or go to, you know, they used to have a little area where there were math students that were really good at math and they sat and they hung out and they tutored other students. And these were resources that my students didn't know, especially if they were online students. They didn't know that they had access to the same types of tutoring that my face-to-face students had. So I saw that very much as my job as a college success teacher to help those students understand what resources were available to them. And who better than New York with supporting students? I mean, you're doing really incredible work. All right, I'm going to start getting weepy because I love New York so much. All right, so let's say I've chatted with this student. I can also click on the student and I get a quick profile. I can get an at a glance. So let's say Justin, you know, booked me for online office hours, and I was kind of, you know, really jogging my memory here of what's going on with this student. I can see, all right, so Justin Nguyen here is really struggling with the internet at his house. So, you know, the online resources might be a little difficult for him. I might want to remind him of the PDF, and I might want to show him on his phone how he can interact with Waymaker, because it renders beautifully on a tablet or on his phone. So these are some of the ways that we save teachers' time. The other thing that I want to show you, since we've got about 3 minutes, and I want to make sure that I can wrap up and give a minute for some questions, is I want to go back to basically the faculty resources, just to show you. I think I briefly showed those, but just to go into some details, we do have those assignments. The other unpublished folder we have is, you know, how to set up your course. And someone like me or someone like Laura can walk you through. Setting up a course can take anywhere from 5 minutes to an hour. And then once you have the course set up, you're ready to go and you just copy from term to term. And so this is the really quick overview of College Success, and we've got about 3 minutes left. So I'll stop there, I'll stop sharing, and see if we have any questions or if there's anything that I can do to explain more about Lumen's College Success.
All right, so if there aren't any questions, just a reminder that if you think of any questions later at any time, you can shoot out an email to oer@suny.edu. And again, that gets filtered right through the SUNY Help Desk, our dedicated team of people there that deal with any of our OER questions, issues. They will filter it out either to one of us in the SUNY OER services team, and or off to the Lumen team. And again, if you're interested in having kind of a demo course so that you can play around and take a look at that, we can certainly have that set up for you. And you can look at any of those courses that are the Ready Adopt courses, Ready to Go, catalog at oer.suny.edu. And if there aren't any questions, thank you for attending and watching, and have a great day.
Yeah, thanks everyone.
Thank you.
Thanks.